Welcome to this tutorial on how to create binomial trees in Excel. A binomial tree is an options pricing model used to figure out the value of a call or a put option at time zero based on the future value of the stock or the potential value of the stock at these different time periods. This would be the stock value at time zero or period zero. Period one, it could either go up or down. We only have two options. A stock can move up or down. It could hypothetically stay the same. In the second period, it could go up again for the second time. So S times U squared. It could go down from up. So S times U times D, which is up times down. Or it could go down again. And again, this just branches out over and over and over. And this is what's known as a binomial tree. In Excel, it will look a little something like this. This is a 200-step binomial tree I did back in my derivatives class in college. We have our stock value here. Here's time zero. All the way over here, we have our period 200. And if we scroll all the way down, we might have to zoom out here. This is my call value. And if we go scroll even further, we'll see this is my put value. So this is kind of how it's going to look. It's not going to look quite as nice as this little graphic here, but this is going to be the easiest way to do it in Excel, where we can easily take a formula and drag it across to create our trees. In this example, I'm just going to use a 10-period one. It's smaller, it's easier to work with. You don't have to worry about making sure that these two formulas overlap. That's kind of why I have these ones here. I'm using them just as a general template for your viewing pleasure. But we are going to be looking at my tree to kind of see how it works, look at the formula, and then we're going to take that formula and apply it to our own model. So you'll see this formula here is an if statement followed by another if statement. It looks kind of long, a little complicating. So here's some visuals to help us break this formula down. It's basically saying if this logic is true, we're going to do this. And if it's false, we're going to do this. And in our binomial tree, we have three scenarios. So if E15 and E14 are blank, therefore the cell must be blank. So here's our formula right here. So if the cell before it is blank and the cell before and up is blank, therefore this must be blank. That's scenario one. And that is what this code right here is explaining. So if E15 is blank, then we're going to go do this. And if E14 is blank, therefore these two things are true, so this must equal blank. This brings us to scenario two. So if E15 is blank, but E14 is not blank, so therefore this must be false and this is true, we are going to do this, which is E14 multiplied by 1 plus F9. F9 is our percent down that the stock is going to go every period. So in this case, it's going to be 10%. And then our third scenario would be if E15 is not blank, then we must compute E15 multiplied by the percent up, which is this right here. So if this is not true, we must compute this, which is just take the cell right in front of it and multiply it by the percent going up, which in this case is 10%. Let's go ahead and apply this to our own tree right here. Whoops. So at time period zero, our stock is equal to 50. That's what we have up here. So our formula is actually going to start in the first period. And we are going to simply start doing that if statement. So if the cell in front of it is equal to blank, and if the cell above it is also equal to blank, therefore this cell must be blank. But remember, if it is not blank, we're going to take this value, B12, and multiply it by the percent down. So 1 plus the percent down. And then the value, if B13 is actually not blank, we're going to take B13, multiply it by 1 plus the percent going up, which is 10%. And hit enter. Now we're going to take this formula, we're going to drag it all the way to the right, and then all the way down. And so what we have here is the same formula, except we're just applying it to our own spreadsheet. As you can see, these also have formulas, but they're blank because, remember, scenario one, if E20 is blank and the cell above it is blank, therefore this cell must be blank. But the reason why this cell is not blank is because, remember, this is blank, but this is not blank. Therefore, this cell must be the cell in the adjacent northwest corner multiplied by the percent down, which is exactly what this is. If you want to test this, you would simply take 50 times 1.1 and then 50 times 0.9. And you could also try it again, 55 times 1.1 and 55 times 0.9, you're going to get these values. Now, the second step to our formula is to work on our formula for the call option. Our call formula is simply right here. It's our basic binomial model. So it's going to be the percent or the probability of the call option up plus y minus p, call option down, all over 1 plus R, which is the risk-free rate. I have all three of these things right here. So all we need is the CU and the CD, which is going to be based off of the stock price. Let's go back to our old formula that I have here. We'll hit F2 to check it out. So this is actually working backwards now. We're looking to the right, not to the left. And it's saying if C18 is blank, this cell must be blank. But if it's not blank, we must compute this one formula. And this formula is actually what I have right here. So let's go ahead and start computing this. So if this cell is equal to blank, this must be blank. But if it's not, we must compute this formula, which is going to be P multiplied by the adjacent cell plus multiplied by 1 minus P. And actually, I'm missing some parentheses here. We have to do this all over 1 plus R, which means this whole section needs to be in parentheses, divided by 1 plus our risk-free rate, which is 3.5%. And then close this out, hit enter. So now we're going to take this, we're going to drag it all the way over, and then all the way down. And it is blank. The reason why it's blank is simple. It's constantly looking to the right. There's no values over here. So what we have to do at the max period is find the payoff of the call option. And the payoff is going to be either our stock price minus our exercise price, which is 25. We have our stock price of 50. Actually, you just look at the stock price over here. Minus 25 or 0. So we're going to do the equals max our stock price minus our exercise price. Hit F4. Or 0. Because you're either going to get a payoff or you're not. Hit enter. We're going to have to bring this formula down to, I believe, here. Whoops, I did one too many there. And there you have it. So now it has, this formula has something to pull back on. and it's just going to keep working its way backwards to square one.